All right, time for some more Alan Wake.
Recognize the logo on the power plant sign. I'd seen a version of it painted all over the area, signifying hidden caches of supplies.
Coincidence? I think not.
Hold it right there!
Miss Weaver! Cynthia! I'm a friend!
Prove it!
You knew Zane, Thomas Zane. You're the Lady of the Light in the song. You can help me.
About time. Young man, I've been waiting a very long time for you.
It's in the well-lit room.
Excuse me?
What you need to drive the darkness back. The well-lit room's at the dam. I built the room to keep it safe.
Will it help me find Alice? Will it get me back to the cabin? Fine, let's go. I can get my friends to come back with the helicopter.
We won't go outside. Never at night. That's rule number one. You've been breaking the rules, young man, and where has that gotten us,
Sorry about that. Uninvited guest.
Something was damaged at the transformer yard. It's draining all the reserve power. Without it, the pipe will go dark. The power to the yard must be cut.
Let me guess. You want me to do it?
Young man, you're the one who likes to break the rules. I can't be outside in the dark. Kill switch is outside. Hurry! The switch is on the wall facing the shore.
Sent me to cut the power to the transformer yard. I was willing to do grunt work for her to get her to help me. I hoped Weaver was dependable. I'd stumbled into this crazy world a little over a week ago. She had been living this insanity for decades. I could see the kill switch that would cut the power to the transformer yard. Now I had to find a way to reach it. If I could figure out the gates, I could use them to get to the kill switch.
Do it. Too overzealous. Okay.
The transformer yard went dark and dead. Weaver's water pipe passage should now be good to go.
This way, young man. Follow me. Come, come. The pipe's empty now. We're ready to go. This way. We need to go.
I knew them both, Tom and Barbara. I had such a crush on him. Such a beautiful man. I was jealous. There was a part of me that was maybe a little glad when she had the accident. And then Tom started writing and woke the darkness up. He tried to bring her back, but you can't do that. There are no free rides like that.
I'm starting to realize that.
In that case, young man, perhaps you're a smarter man than Tom was. Witch looked like her, but it wasn't. Barbara was sweet. He didn't understand until it was too late. He tried to undo it, wrote himself, her, everything he'd ever written out of the world. Oh, he was so famous. And afterward, no one knew. Oh, Tom. He left only one thing behind in my name, in case it happened again. Insurance. He trusted me. Or perhaps used me a little. Tom knew how I felt. Knew I wouldn't refuse him. I built the well-lit room right there. It's been waiting for you. We are characters trapped in a story. And none of us will survive to see the end of it if the darkness isn't stopped. She'll twist the story to her own dark ends.
How do you know all this?
Tom, that's the way he wrote it. He still talks to me, you know, in television, beyond, from below. We have both been touched by the darkness, young man.
Oh, good
he
lord.
Saved us both with light.
Barbara, step aside. I'd take care of the wheel myself. I could get it open much faster.
This pipe will take us directly to the well-lit room.
Okay, I need to call my friends, tell them where we're going.
Hello? Ow!
Barry, we're headed to the dam in one of the pipes. Meet us there.
Okay, I'll tell Sarah.
It's Sarah now? We gotta go see if they're okay.
They're probably dead. You must reach the well-lit room. This is no time to be a selfish idiot.
That's my best friend!
Well, be a fool. I'll use the pipe. I'll meet you at the dam if you make it.
I didn't have to worry about her. She knew how to stay safe. Sarah was almost starting to relax. Maybe they could turn this into a win yet. Suddenly, there was a piercing sound, like a table saw gone wild, as 100 birds made out of shadow swarmed into the rotor. The chopper bucked wildly and the board lit up, telling her what she already knew. They were going down. Barry Wheeler screamed next to her.
Alfred Hitchcock's The Birds.
crash site looked bad, but as far as I could tell, the wreck was empty.
Cassidy and the Sundance Kid.
I have a different ending in mind.
Yeah, I'm fine. Thanks for asking.
I knew you'd be all right.
How's that?
The Flaming Eye of Mordor?
Laugh it up, funny man. Didn't we have somewhere to go?
Weaver will meet us at the dam.
Safe.
That was... wow. I think we're okay.
Hey, Al, I got a bad feeling.
Let's keep our eyes open.
Oh! We made it. We're not dead.
Yet.
Wait, call the elevator. I'm keeping watch.
I think I hear something moving around.
Thank you. almost there. There's an entrance into the dam at the top. What's the plan, Wake?
Well, Weaver's crazy, but she's got something Zane left behind. Something to fix this.
Gee, could you be a little more vague?
Thomas Zane? Seriously? Might as well be Paul Bunyan or Bigfoot.
Yeah, well, he was real.
Zane knew he had to remove all that had made this horror possible, including himself. That was the only way to banish the dark presence he had unleashed and now looked at him through the eyes of his dead love. But he also knew that despite his best efforts, it might someday return. So even as he wrote himself and his work out of existence, he added a loophole as insurance, an exception to the rule. Anything of his stored in a shoebox would remain.
further.
You can stop running in place now.
You made it. Well done. Glad I was wrong. But it was a foolish chance to take. Don't worry about the noise. We're safe here. I have looked after the well-lit room for many, many years now. There is no shadow in the well-lit room. The power is fail-safe, and all the bulbs are numbered and changed regularly based on their make and model.
Right.
Because 6 and 33 and 118 need changing soon, and I don't want to climb up the ladder to change them because it's very late and I'm tired. And if you take it, I won't have to do that anymore.
The page was autobiographical, a memory from my childhood. But I didn't write this. It was a page written by Thomas Zane. None of them were supposed to exist anymore.
Alan, 7 years old, would fight sleep to the bitter end. When he did sleep, he soon woke up, screaming, the nightmares fresh in his mind. One evening, his mother, sitting by his bed, offered him an old light switch. She called it the clicker, and flicking the switch would turn on a magical light that would drive the beast away. To imbue the talisman with all possible power, she added that it had been given to her by Alan's father. Alan never knew him, and anything of his took on mythical proportions in his mind. With the clicker firmly in his hand, Alan finally slept like a baby. Now, almost 30 years later, Alan thought of this as he stood on the rim of Cauldron Lake, the clicker in his hand. He took a deep breath and jumped.
My mind swirled. I'd given the clicker to Alice, yet it was here. Zane had written it into existence in a story I had written. I can get to her now. I can finish this. Previously on Alan Wake, I wrote a horror story that has come true. Thomas Zane did the same in the 70s.
You will go no further.
If I continue like the Dark Presence wants me to, the story I'm writing won't save Alice. It's a horror story. No one will survive.
You knew Zane! Thomas Zane! You're the Lady of the Light in the song!
He left something behind to help me. The clicker.
Alan thought of this as he stood on the rim of Cauldron Lake, the clicker in his hand. He took a deep breath and jumped.
I can get to her now. I can finish this.
Departure.
Oh.
was about to explode and the light hurt my eyes. I needed my sunglasses and painkillers to dull the pain. In one of my finer moments of self-deception, I swore to quit drinking. The sunglasses made the world look bearable. Now I could keep my eyes open without feeling like a vampire in the sun. I wasn't sure I'd make it out there without some painkillers. The pills worked fast. The prospect of being awake started to seem bearable again. There was a message waiting for me on the machine.
Congratulations. That's great to hear. So, how's the publicity tour been treating you?
Good. Great. But I gotta say, I'm glad to be back home in New York.
Well, you've certainly been on the news a lot lately. Lots of parties and, you got into a fight with some paparazzi.
Oh, man. Well, that guy was really in my face. I lost my temper. I know that wasn't cool.
You are famous for that temper.
Did also write several books.
Well, your latest novel is called The Sudden Stop, and it's in bookstores now. Go get it. That means the two of you out there who haven't bought it yet. Ladies and gentlemen, that's all we have for you tonight. I want to thank all our guests for the evening, Alan Wake, Sam Lake, and once more, do the face for a sin. And our musical guests, Poets of the Fall. Thank you.
At least I've been funny. I told myself I could live with that.
Hey, honey. Did you watch the show?
I didn't say anything stupid, if that's what you want to know.
Okay, Grumpy. Want to ask me something?
Are you going to start with me about drinking now?
You know what? Go back to sleep, Alan.
What? Now you can't even talk to me?
Well, this morning I was angry because you said you'd be home at midnight and you showed up at 7 a.m. and passed out in mid-sentence. Now I'm over it. Are you angry?
This goddamn tour. It's gotten out of hand.
Oh, honey. It's almost over, right? We can get back to normal, and you can start writing again.
I'm sorry, honey.
Alan, you're not thinking straight. Just take a shower and go back to bed, huh?
Yeah, you're right, honey. I'm sorry. Once this is over, let's go away together. A vacation. Just you and me. Some peace and quiet. Somehow, the clicker was the key to the cabin. I had to return to Cauldron Lake to save Alice. I'm going back to the lake to finish this. I'm going to write an ending to the story in the manuscript on my own terms, to make it all right.
Why can't you just write it here?
The last page is still in the typewriter. I need to read it first. Everything needs to be just right. Zane tried to cut some corners, and it didn't end well.
Okay, ready when you are.
I'm sorry, Sarah, but I need to do this alone. Barry, take her gun. Miss Weaver, close the door when I leave.
Good luck, Al.
See you later. When I got out, it was warm and sunny. I'd flicked the switch of the clicker. Had it done this? I didn't stop to question it. I had to take advantage of the sunlight to get to the lake. On Zane's page, I'd stood on the rim of the lake, about to use the clicker. That's where I was headed. Surrounded by the beauty of the Pacific Northwest landscape, it was hard not to let doubt creep in one last time. I could still chalk everything up to a dream, a delusion. I had enough imagination to make up something like this, having been in the cabin all this time, trapped in a story inside my head, gone mad from grief over Alice's death like Hartman had claimed. There would be no way of knowing. I told myself it didn't really matter. My course was set. I could feel its presence again getting closer. The Dark Presence was no longer trying to capture the Rider so he could create the ending it wanted. The Rider knew too much. He was too strong. And he carried a weapon left behind by Thomas Zane, something that could hurt it. Now, the darkness was doing everything in its power to simply stop the Rider from ever reaching Cauldron Lake and the dark place it came from. Based on the signature in the motel register, Agent Nightingale had stayed here, in room number 2.
The Majestic Motel. General information. Refundable $100. Security deposit is required on all reservations. No personal checks accepted. Take all major credit cards and bank cards. Checkout time is 10 a.m. No loud music. No pets. One vehicle per unit. Facilities are for registered guests only. No visitors are allowed on the premises after 9 p.m. No exemptions. We hope you enjoy your stay at the Majestic. If you're a senior event, ask about our discounts. Not too hard.
graveyard of things the lake had claimed in one way or another over the decades. The Dark Presence brought them up in its wake, scattering the rotten, waterlogged hull of an old boat here, the remains of a long-ago crashed airplane there. Trees shattered under the impacts. The earth groaned. It didn't even notice. Zane cut its heart out, but it didn't die. The thing that wore Barbara's face kept crooning sweet nothings, sugar-laced with poison. He put on the suit, untied the monster from the chair. The thing in his arms thrashed weakly, but he held fast. He stepped outside, off the pier, and into the dark water, a sinking pinprick of light descending toward a bottom that never came. Thank you.
is that he can't hurt me.
As if I knew what I was doing. I didn't. I was operating on the shifting logic of a dream. I had to fight my way to the lake through the horrors of the night. I had to flick an old battered light switch imbued with childhood magic. I had to write a happy ending to a horror story. I had to save my wife from the dark prison she was being held in.
I will never give her to you.
Thank you.
place I found myself in was unlike anything I could ever have imagined. It wasn't solid. It flowed. It was conceptual and subjective. For someone else, an artist in another field, it would have been very different. I could sense the story of the manuscript all around me. The words and ideas floating in the air, poised to become real. In the distance. That's where Cauldron Lake was.
sakes. Really? But the good news is I don't have to start so far back. I guess it counts for something. Oh, really? Just because I hit shift in, shift in time? That's not gonna count for anything? Seriously? Wow. That's just sad. Dodged that time, I still got there. Really losing my patience now. Yeah, I hit shift in time, and I still get hit. That doesn't make any sense. There we go.
After Zane had gone, I stood alone in the shifting dream that was the dark place. I had to find a way to the cabin. I'd written myself a way through this place in the manuscript. I followed the idea of a path. I'd written myself across the ocean that blocked my way, and with that, there was a bridge to the island beyond. The idea of the cabin flickered in the underwater darkness. I willed the cabin to be real, and it was. right into its heart to hurt it.
Really? That, ladies and gentlemen, is a good way to break your legs.
Shh, baby. You were having a bad dream. It was just another nightmare.
No.
Everything's fine. You're home.
It wasn't a dream.
Everything's fine.
Turn the lights on. Turn the lights on!
Out. There's no light. Come back to bed and I'll make you forget all about your fear in the dark.
My fear? It's your fear. Why aren't you afraid?
You're not Alice. Turn the lights on now. Where's the clicker? What did you do with it?
Alan? You're scaring me now. Come back to bed. Have you taken your pills? Do you want me to call Dr. Hartman?
I read your manuscript. It's brilliant. Departure is your best work yet. You're a genius. I'm so proud of you. Come back to bed. We'll talk more about it in the morning.
Come back to bed, Alan.
Come back to bed, Tom.
Find your way to the cabin. It stands in your way. It won't let you pass. It has no heart. It's filled with darkness. You must fill its heart with light. Don't mind him. He's Mr. Scott. Your friends will meet him when you're gone. Use the clicker.
What?
I'm leaving you, Alan. I met someone. I'm in love with someone else.
Alice? No, what do you say? You can't...
You don't love me. I hate you. You don't even love yourself. All you do is torture yourself with work you can't do anymore.
No, I love you more than anything in the world. You're my muse. Who are you? What have you done with my Alice?
Alan?
It wasn't true. Nothing like that had ever happened.
You're not my Barbara.
Tom, let me go. I promise to be good. Please, untie me, you naughty boy. I will help you watch your masterpiece. I will love you forever.
No, you're not Barbara Jagger. I made a terrible mistake. I should have never written you back. You came back wrong. Your heart is filled with darkness.
Put that knife away, Thomas. Put it down.
My heart is filled with darkness. Cut it out.
Ah!
I'll take you back to the depths of paper.
Your husband refused to do as he was told. All he had to do was write what I wanted him to write.
Now you will never get her back.
I am much older than you.
Older than your first work of art. I will find a new face to wear. Someone else to dream me free.
I could feel Alice's presence close by. I understood what I had to do now. I knew how to write the ending to Departure. There's light and there's darkness. Cause and effect. There's guilt and there's atonement. But the scales always need to balance. Everything has a price. That's where Zane had gone wrong. There's a long journey through the night back into the light.
Now.
that was quite a trip. Nothing on that note here. I will see you all next time.